Hi, my name is Kris Hudson with Martin Deerline. In this video today, we're going to talk about maintenance on the active tailing system on the John Deere combine. First thing you got to do, we already took it off, you got to take the shield off, pull it down to access. Underneath here, there's a chain. It's a continuous chain. There's an adjustment behind that board here. There's a guide on it, similar style to all the other ones in the combine where you can adjust to the notch. It's a little tough to see from here, but you can just adjust them. So your tension, the nut reaches the tension guide. This chain takes a lot of abuse in the season. It gets forgot about quite often. It's three bolts to get the shield off, and then the shield comes down. So as the season progresses, if we start getting into some tough, snotty conditions late in the fall, or even early in the season with some peas, there's an access panel on the top side of the cylinder itself. If you're able to come up here with a ladder, you can actually see what kind of material is building up inside that thrashing element itself. A couple of spots to really check is if you can get down here and actually see what's building up between the auger and the cylinder itself inside. If you are finding you're slipping this system and your slip clutch is going off quite often, it's serviced the same as the feeder hose slip clutch. Give it a couple pumps of grease. It's a radial pin style slip clutch, so you want to get a little bit of grease on the inside there and protect those pins. For infield setting with your active tailings, you have two positions. You got the wheat position and the corn position. For wheat, absolutely have it down in the wheat position. If you're in peas or tough, some canola conditions, you'd want to slip that up into the corn position. That just allows a bigger space inside the active tailings, so you're not grinding your peas or over thrashing your canola. Okay, we're over here on the left side of the combine. We've taken off the separator shields themselves. We just want to have a quick look on the inside of the combine. This is where the active tailing system actually returns to the grain pan, and then it shifts the material back to the front of the cleaning chute. If you are having some issues with tailings plugging, just check and make sure that this area underneath and then inside the tube is actually able, it's clean, and it's actually able to put the material back down properly on the pan itself. If that system starts to back up, you get into a tough spot where there's some tough material coming through the combine, maybe that material will not actually be able to get out of the tailing system itself. There's three different spots. There's one hole here on the left side on the inside, there's one here a little bit closer to the rotor, then there's one more on the right side of the combine to have a look at.